Okay, Andre was kind enough to get me a nice chukka from Adcan Marine. So look at this chukka, absolutely beautiful. Very nice chukka. I'm just letting it defrost. Not gonna throw this head away, because that would be probably, if the chips are down and the fish are quiet, I'm gonna make a bait with that head and some chukka and try and fish for a duck bill with a decent sized float. The bigger carp tend to like eating that head, so yeah. Guys, what's important is when you are using chukka, there's a nice red eye. This one I actually caught off the boat last week. Went looking for some kuta and we found some bait fish. Still got his scales on. Good job, very, very fresh red eye. Now what's important with your chukka is that you try and keep it cool. So when I'm done, I try and chuck it under the top layer. So it just stays a bit cool. I just find that the chukka works a bit better when it's cool. Just trying to find a cotton. Okay, so I'm gonna make a small bait. So I'm looking for a very small dangle, not a big dangle. Obviously we need to clip and throw here. So I find a very small one, short, very short thing. Ah, there we go. Yeah, that one, perfect. So that's my short dangle. As you can see, very, very short. Made for throwing small baits. Especially those round ball baits. I'm going to show you how we make that ball bait. One hook. That one. So put your hook in. Alright, you've got your dangle. Obviously, we're going to just do a quick measurement here. Oh, got it. I'm going to chop that red eye straight down. And I'm going to chop that nose off. So, take off the gill plates, not necessary. Okay, then what I do is I just shape just the top of that head, just chop that. Chop that. Okay, so basically you got a square piece of meat. This red eye is so fresh that it's just still got its scales on, so it's a bit difficult to work with. Open it up. So I opened it up. And you're gonna place your dangle in and close it. Alright? So basically you've got the entire gearbox inside you with all the flavor and all the smell and everything. Right? Then you're gonna cotton this up, and what's important is how you cotton. So you cotton, huh? It's sort of in place, and then this is how that bait's not going to come off, because I know you guys normally use that and through the lips obviously to hold the bait in place. So if you cotton that way and you're using latex cotton, the latex cotton is so strong that it holds that bait in place and it doesn't come off. So guys, this is just the base of the bait. So obviously the head is inside. And then we're gonna pack some meat in the side. So a few more that way, just to hold it in place. So you can see it's starting to take a little bit of shape. Oops. So tie that off. Okay, now I'm gonna get my balance of my red eye. So I'm gonna take a nice chunk out. Out. Get another chunk. Okay, so while the red eye is still frozen and this one's got scales, you just get under that skin.
You like getting under people's skin, man.
I love getting under people's skin. Here we go. Field. Fleshy bait. It's gonna end up like a ball, basically. There's a little bit of cotton there. Try not to choke the hook. And then up, I'm beating it skin side up first. I'm gonna pulp this chaka, literally pulp it, and then I'm gonna turn it around and hit it on the meat side. Okay, so you're gonna take one piece of chaka on the top. One piece of chaka in the bottom. So you got your red eye on the inside, slow releasing all the blood and the guts, and you got your chaka covering it. So trying to sort of also try and get a better fish, a little bit of a pecker proof bait. If you notice, I'm putting lots of cotton to hold that bait in place. That's what I want. That's it. So that's pretty much what I wanted. Red eye on the inside, chaka on the outside. There's generally a lot of peckers here at the bank. That's gonna stay a little bit longer than just a straight meat bait. And you'll catch a diamond on it, you'll catch a duck bill, you'll catch a sandy, you'll catch a honeycomb, you'll catch everything on this bait. Probably even catch a copper. So this is normally my first bait in the morning, go-to bait when we're fishing this area. And then later start changing over to mackerel and bonnies and all those other fancy baits. But standard issue, mackerel chaka, not bad. Good bait.